I never had a taste for this sort of thing, but I must admit, I'm deeply enjoying the suit.
Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we got Iron Man from Fanhome, issues 71 to 74, plus the 8th installment of the premium base. This is a little bit more interesting this month because we've got a few parts for the torso. There we go. That is a heavy piece of metal, that one. That is for the standard base. We do get the second section of the standard base. It's here somewhere. There we go. That's the second section. There's not much to do with the Iron Man for the issue 71, but what there is we can easily complete. And there we have the eighth section of the premium base stamp. What else was there? And there's some more parts for the torso, I think that is. That's quite heavy as well. Brilliant. I also need a couple of parts all the way back from issue 33. And there's the first half of the standard stand. So, there's quite a bit. Oh, it looks like there's quite a bit. It's quite a big box this month, but this particular issue, well, there's not a great lot to do with that one. But that's been normal with that Fanhome. But at least we're working on the torso, we're not looking on the arms and the legs. So it gets a little bit more interesting this month. But anyway, without further ado, let's get on with the build. Okie doke, issue 71. Let's have a quick run through this. You can see what the parts we have there on the front. Page 3, The History of Iron Man, Industrial Revolution, The Future of a Neighborhood. Tony Stark, I think he's had a few too many there. Entrepreneur Seeks Business, I think this is basically when he's lost his fortune and he's making his way back up again. And he comes across a gang called the Pride. Supernatural Connections oblige the Illuminati to intervene. You have Neymar, Mr. Fantastic, Doctor Strange get involved. James Rhodes, there's Iron Man. And then we have on the next page the instructions and the parts. Here we have the second part of the standard base. You know, the ball joints, leg support cover, and we've got connectors. There's a lower hip armor which we don't actually fit. There we go, those are the instructions. Exploded view. And then page 8 in the comics, Doctor Strange, Master of Mystic Arts. I goes on about his origin story. He was not as popular as other Marvel heroes at the time, and he did get a kind of reboot over the years. And there we have some more about Doctor Strange and the Defenders, one of the groups I was involved in. And then we have God Killer 2, Fighting Galactic Gods. This is when they all became supersized Iron Man, Thor, She-Hulk. I think that's Ghost Rider as well. Excellent stuff. There we go. Next issue, Build the Chest and Base. Thor, God of Thunder. Excellent. Let's get on with the build. So here we have the parts. So let's get them out of the packaging. Okay, so those are the parts that we got. We got the second part of the standard base there with the screws and some supports that will fit later. Now these parts, we do need these two from issue 33. One has got L printed on it, which is that one. Oh, sorry, that's right. And this one has L written on it. Now either of these ball joints will suffice. Pop it through there like that. And then you need to identify this, and it will basically go there, and we'll go two screws, one, two. Excellent stuff. And we'll do the same with the other one.
Official consulting hours are between 8 and 5 every other Thursday.
There we go, that's that one done. Do exactly the same with this one.
Let's face it, this is not the worst thing you've caught me doing.
Six more months of this build and then that's complete. Finishes January next year. Excellent. So, them two are completed. That piece we need later in the build. It is plastic. So we'll pop them to one side. And what we'll do now, we'll do the actual base. Okay, pop these two pieces together there, like that. And these two clips. One there. One down there, like that. Give it some solidity. And then basically, there. And there. And then we just screw that in place. There we go, that's a little bit better. Two screws there, two there, two there, two there, and we've got the clips down here and here. Excellent.
I'm sorry, this is the fun V, the humdrum V is back there.
Well, there we go. There we go. There's the standard base. All nicely done. I didn't notice the camera was playing up before, but that is nicely finished. And here we have the hip joints. Brilliant. And that's spare part for later in the build. So let's get on with issue 72. Okie dokie, issue 72. Let's have a look. Iron Man Noir. Now that is a good read. Year is 1939, so I don't know if we travelled back in time, but in this magazine, it is a very, very good read. So that's something to look out for when you get the issues. And then we have the chest and base. Now, it is a heavy piece of metal, that. There's a support for the support mast for the standard base. We get the art reactor holder with this as well. And this is for switching the art reactor on and off. There we have the support base, not a great lot too, a couple of pins we pop inside, and here we have the exploded view of all the parts. Then we have Thor, Goddess of Thunder. I think this goes on about Jane Foster. There's an upcoming film with Thor. So why is it Thor Love and Thunder, and Jane Foster is in that. In the magazines, or in the comics I should say, Thor loses the ability to use Mjolnir, and Jane Foster picks up the hammer, and she also becomes the goddess Thor. And here I have a picture of her suffering from cancer and having a nice encounter with the Falcon. And on page 12, submarine for armor, target Namor. Namor declared war on surface dwellers. So the superheroes form the team to combat him. That's an excellent read as well. And then that moves on to the next issue. Next issue, build the chest one and base two. Thor, God of Thunder. I thought we'd just done that one. And in this epic issue, Iron Man Noir number one. We have Iron Man and Spider-Man there. Anyway, that's definitely a printing issue. And here we have the parts, so let's get them out of the packaging. Okay, on, here are the parts. Look at that. Now that is a chunky piece of metal, that. Very much so. Now it is going to get covered over, obviously, but that is quite heavy. Basically what we need to do is to put this piece over the top of it. It goes that way around, like that. And we need two EM screws, one there and one there. That's excellent. So that's where the art reactor will sit. There we go. Okay, at this point what we need to do is to marry these two together. There's a bracket here, and this acts as the switch for the art reactor. Pop that through there like that. And then we pop this on here, there like that. Two IP screws. There's the first one. Now here we have the art reactor. This is a modified version. So if I pop this in, we can give it a quick test. Now, there's the switch, the button for the switch. So that will go to the bottom. There we go. That is now in place. And we press this rod to support the front of the art reactor. And hopefully it should switch it on. There it is. Excellent stuff. Okay, now we've got the mast support. We just need to put these two pieces together. Now there is a little location tab there. Can you see that? So if we pop this into place here, it will. Oh, it's gone in first time. Brilliant. Then all we need to do is put two pins through here, through them two holes, and tap them into place if need be with a hammer. Piece of wood for support there, and just tap that in to place. Excellent. And the second one, stay there, boy. There we go. Excellent, nice and flush. Then all that's left to do is to put some tape. One of these pieces of tape over the end here. Okay, now they call this adjustment tape. It's to make it easier to put into the base. Just wrap that round. There we go. Excellent. There we go. Those are those two pins. Excellent stuff. So there we go, that's what we've done with issue 72. Support mast and this chest piece. Pop the reactor in. Excellent. Let's move on to 73. Here we go, issue 73. We have Carnage Returns, two against the symbiote. Looks like we've got a collaboration of Iron Man and Spider-Man. The return of Carnage, one of the deadliest villains in Spider-Man, as a wall crawler up against the ropes. Luckily, Spidey receives help from his fellow Avenger, Iron Man. That was over three pages, and here we have some excellent artwork. Venom with Iron Man and his big blasters. And then we have the parts, the chest part 2 and the base part 3. So you have a breastplate element 1, element 2, neck armor, and two support brackets, spring and adhesive strips. And here we have the instructions. Turn over for more instructions, and we put the mast support into the base itself. Then we have an exploded view. And then back onto the comics. The Avengers 60 Glorious Years. Lovely artwork. Absolutely brilliant. I used to have a copy of this, The Earth's Mightiest Heroes, number one. Still might have somewhere. I think it's got a bit of a rip in it though. There we go. Avengers Assemble again and again. Captain Marvel, She-Hulk. And on page 12, the armor, Godbuster, Iron Man Reloaded. Oh, it's a little bit scary. And then for the next issue, Build the Chest Part 3, Fix Me Brain Drain. There we go, epic issue. This one, Carnage Volume Number 1. So let's move on to the parts. And here we have the parts, so let's get them out of the packaging. Okay, those are all the parts. I'll pop them to one side because that's for the support mast. We've got the breastplate and we got these two details and pads for that as well. That is plastic. These are all plastic. We need the IP screws for these. Basically these will fit here and here, and right, there we go, and eyepiece screws at the back. There we go, those are those two elements in place, left and right. Get them the right way around as well. There we go, just follow the instructions, can't go wrong. And then what we need is the neck support, so we can pop that on there like that. There's one, two screw mounting points there, and the tabs, one, two, fit neatly there as well. And we need two IP screws.
I swear to God, I'll dismantle you, I'll soak your motherboard, I'll turn you into a wine rack.
There we go. That's the breastplate on the neck support. Excellent stuff. Now we can connect that up to this large chest piece. Basically, that will go on here like that, looking absolutely brilliant. And then we need to secure that at the back, underneath, should say, and then the screws to line up. Yep, two screws, one, two.
Sir, the reactor has accepted the modified core. I will begin running diagnostics.
There we go. Brilliant. That is looking superb. Excellent stuff. Now we can pop that to one side and we can have a look at this for the support stand. Now we got some sticky pads here, we can take them off, and basically we need to put these sticky pads along here and inside here, obviously, to support the model. Now should be able to get it there, just like that, line that up. Lovely jubbly, there it is. We can do it again. Sticky this. There we go. Excellent. And then we can pop the spring in there and that in there like that. As you can see, that's how that goes. That will work. Excellent stuff. And we need to pop a screw in here, which is a GM screw. Pop a little bit of oil on that screw and pop that down there. Nice and tight. Excellent. There we go. Brilliant stuff. Now what we need is this support mast. Move that. So the instructions want us to put it in the third and fourth hole. Just make sure you press it all the way down, just like that, so it's a nice snug fit there, and then we can screw away.
You have reached the life model decoy of Tony Stark, please leave a message.
And that's the second one. There we go. There's the support mast and the grip. Excellent stuff. So now we got the standard base, and we can pop that in there. There we go. That should hold our Iron Man. There we go. Excellent stuff. Okay, issue 74. Let's have a look, a quick look. Here we are. History of Iron Man, Fix Me Brain Drain. January 27th saw the publication of landmark 500th issue of Iron Man, which began an epic story written by Matt Fraction and illustrated by artist Salvador La Roca. I was on for three pages with Spidey again. Looks like Doc Ock was involved here. And then we have the parts. So you have the breastplate mechanism. There it is. That just sits over the top. A couple of IP screws. There we go. Four, actually. And we have the exploded view, and it shows you whereabouts it's going. And we do put the figure together. And then page 8. In the comics, Dark Avengers, Norman Osborn's Insanity, Green Goblin. Here are some more cracking artwork. Captain Marvel, Sentry, Miss Marvel, Ares, Wolverine, Hawkeye, and the Amazing Spider-Man. I was on for four pages, so that'll be an excellent read. I haven't actually read this one yet. And on page 12, the armor, cropped up armor, the ghost of Tony Stark. Excellent artwork. There we have Tony Stark with Captain Marvel. Illustration for the cover of Tony Stark, Iron Man number 14. And then, next issue. So that'll be next month. Build the Chest, Part 4, Iron Man and Thor, God Complex. Excellent, let's get the parts out. And here we have the parts. There we go, that's all plastic. That fits like that, I believe. So let's get this piece over with. There we go. So all we need to do with this is to fit this over here. There are four mounting points. 1, 2, 3, 4 tabs there for the to pop through for the screws. That fits there like that. There we go. That's that on in place there. It is quite a tight fit. So just be aware of that to get these screw mounting points correctly lined up, but it's all nice and bonny now. So now we can go ahead and use four IP screws to connect it all up. There we go. Those are the four screws in place now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. And that's how it looks now. Pop this back in again, switch to the bottom. There we go. There we go. There's the breastplate in place and the art reactor. There we go. Switches on and off, no problem. Well, there we go. That's looking absolutely brilliant now. Nice modification that from Mr. Fusion Designs. It's better than the standard one, which is just basically a white light. But that looks absolutely fantastic. So that is that. That is issue 71, 74 complete. We have the basic stand. All that off now. There we go. Hip joints and that piece. Excellent. All we need to do now is the premium base stand. Here we go. There is the 8th section of the premium base stand. So I'll get this out of the packaging and pop it in and show you in a second or two. Okie doke. Now we got the two parts together. We just need HM screws here, four of, and then we'll attach it to the rest of the base with iron screws. As always, with going into metal, a little bit of oil won't go amiss. So that's the first one. And this is the last one. Nice and tight. Excellent stuff. Okay, don't get them. Bring the base over. And pop that. You can see where it's got to go. It's going to be a little bit awkward. There we go. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws. IM screws, I think, yeah? Yep. There we go. Let's get these in place. There we go. That's all 7 screws in place. Have a quick look at it on the other camera. There we go. There she is. It's not off. Lights are right. There she is. That is massive compared to the basic one. Just for size comparison, put the basic one on top. Look at that breastplate there. There we go. Excellent stuff. You can see the size comparison. That's just about the middle part of this premium base stand. So all this will light up, which we haven't got yet, but will be coming in the next few issues. But that looks brilliant. That don't look too bad either, to be honest. Excellent stuff. So that is all 71 to 74. And the premium base completed for this month. Let's have another quick look at this breastplate. Chest area. Very heavy piece of metal that. That is looking brilliant. There we go. Switches on for me. Brilliant stuff. Excellent. Loving it. Much better than doing legs and arms. Eh? Well, anyway. If you did enjoy that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month for the next 4 issues. What are we up to? 74, 26 more issues. Let's see, we will finish January next year, so that is absolutely brilliant. Just in time for, I think it's the Batmobile Tumbler from Hachette. I don't know when the Eagle Moss Batmobile 1960s version is coming out, but anyway. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and bye for now.